Nature-friendly farming does give me hope. Growing healthy food for the table in a way that allows nature to thrive. It's such a big pick-me-up, and it just kind of spurs you on to do more and see what you can do next. I'm Georgie Bray and I'm farm manager at RSPB's Hope Farm. Hope Farm is just west of Cambridge, owned by the RSPB for 24 years with our main aims to demonstrate and research nature and climate friendly farming. So nature friendly farming in itself is farming in a way where you're working with nature. So nature is incredibly important on farms. We need it to grow food. So our apples, our peas, our beans, they need pollination and so need pollinators. We've got things living below the ground that they process nutrients, they keep that biology alive. And a soil without biology simply isn't going to function in a way to have healthy roots so that our plants can grow and grow well. So by farming in a nature-friendly way, we can take the lessons from the old and the new and farm in a way that is still plentiful, still producing lots of food at good yields, but making that space for nature at the same time. In the last half century or so, farming has changed and nature has declined. We've taken out hedgerows and all sorts of things to intensify production. When we're thinking about nature-friendly farming, that means having connected habitats across the landscape. To keep it really simple, that means that the wildlife that we have on farm needs to have something to eat, it needs to have somewhere to breed. But here, down in sort of lowland and arable mixed farming, there are some specific habitats that we can put in place. Thinking about our wildflower margins that are diverse and full of colour by having ponds, seed-rich habitats for feed birds over winter, hedgerows that are flourishing, diverse, and providing nesting and foraging habitat and all sorts, so that we've got a food system that's working for nature and we've got those connected habitats around the edges of the field. When we go into the crops, we can think of practices old and new that are going to benefit wildlife and actually help build our resilience into the farming system as well. By integrating livestock, we are actually adding that organic matter and they're processing that grass and putting it straight on the ground, which is great for insects, it's great for the soil, it's diversifying the whole business. But then by having all those insects and feeding that soil, that's also great for farmland birds, things like starlings, swallows, all sorts of things. That's going to be really beneficial for them as well. And when you walk out on the farm and you hear wildlife, you can see it thriving, it's just, it's such a good feeling and it just feels right, as cheesy as that sounds. Even now we're experiencing changes to the way that we are having to farm and deal with real fluctuations in weather, from droughts right through to the floods that we've had over the last winter, and it's making farming really tricky. If we're thinking about in-field management and making that good for nature, we are working on improving the soil biology. If we've got healthier soil, we've got crops which are better able to access the nutrients and able to grow better, have more stable roots. All of these things together should mean that we can also reduce our inputs. If farmers are able to see the benefits of what they're doing, if they can see that they are not having to apply so many fertilisers, the pesticides, if they're not needed anymore, it might take a little bit, but you're starting to build that system that is more diverse, more sustainable long term. I've never met a farmer in my life who doesn't want to have nature on their farm, but to farm in a way that is inherently nature friendly and really helping wildlife to thrive can be difficult. If you have a more conventional or intensive farm that has less spaces for nature, to then transition that to a nature friendly way of farming, it's going to mean changes to a farm business. And we are already in a really tricky time. We've got changing to like crop prices, concerns about where the money is coming from and supporting and subsidies, changes to the weather that is making it really hard for farmers to know whether they're going to be making money from 1 month or 1 year to the next. If there's more advice out there to make it an easier transition for a farmer and more knowledge to show and demonstrate how good nature-friendly farming can be for business resilience, they're all things that can make it much easier for a farmer to move to do things in a more nature-friendly way. Nature-friendly farming does give me hope. There's nothing like it when you're walking out onto your farm and you're seeing your crops growing well and you're thinking, yeah, that's great, that's going to go well. It's such a big pick-me-up and it just kind of spurs you on to do more and see what you can do next.